You've probably seen rain travel back to Earth, straight down, at an angle, or even blown sideways in stormy winds. But which direction do all those raindrops travel after they hit the Earth? Do they collect in a polite little puddle waiting to evaporate and make up the next rainfall? Not exactly. Their path is now determined by the force of gravity and geography, a journey that could be measured in minutes or thousands of years, and thousands of miles. A new dimension of time and space known as the watershed zone. What is a watershed? Well, it's not a shed filled with water. We're talking about a big area of land that acts as a natural drainage path for precipitation to travel into a specific body of water. There are sections of sloping land, hills, and valleys that connect to form each watershed. And a bunch of small watersheds can make up one giant watershed. Picture for a moment which direction the water flows down your street. When water flows through cities or across fields, the water picks up dirt, pollutants, and heat. These contaminants flow directly into our streams, wetlands, or lakes, affecting the water you use to drink, swim, or fish. Where the water goes impacts water quality in your watershed. All of us live in a watershed. What you do at home, at work, and in your community affects the water quality in your watershed, all the way into the Gulf of Mexico. When water becomes polluted, it's bad for people, wildlife, and our aquatic habitats. Everyone has a role in finding and helping to prevent water pollution. Water is a precious natural resource, and it is vital to every Texan's quality of life.